Hello everyone, in our previous lesson we added our Active Directory server to our firewall. Thanks to this integration we will be able to create rules using our users in Active Directory. Now let's go to the firewall side and show you how to create user-based rules. Let's come to Firewall Policy under the Policy and Object tab. Here we have a rule that we have already created here, under which we can control by users by selecting user groups. Before you do this, you need to check whether the users in this subnet can access the Active Directory server. We have previously added rules for VLAN 11 and VLAN 12 here. If you do not have this rule, do not forget to add it. If you do not add this rule, users will not be able to access Active Directory services and you will have authentication problems. After disabling NAT here, let's go into our rule and add our users. We click on the plus in the source section and come to the user tab. Here you can see the groups we have created on the firewall side, and on the lower side you can see the groups on the Active Directory side. Since he wrote here as a long, we simplified it by creating new groups. I choose the IT group and I say OK. Now we have two criteria in this rule. You need to be in both IT group and VLAN 11 or VLAN 12 subnet. Now let's go to a host that has joined the domain in VLAN 11 subnet and perform our tests. When we come to the host side, I log in with the Yavuz Bulut user in the IT group. Let's open our web browser and try to access a site. Let's open another page. As you can see, this user has access. Let's try it with another user. Let's change the user here. I am logging in with IK user. Let's open our web browser and try to access the internet. We are currently trying to access the internet, but this user cannot access the internet because they do not have permission. Let's try IT user. I am logging in with IT user. Let's open our web browser and try to access the internet. As you can see, this user has access permission. Now let's go to the firewall side and check our logs. Let's come to the forward traffic tab under log and report. I'm removing the filter from here. Now we can see the usernames in the source section. Now let's log in again with IK user. Let's log in with IK user here. You can see that there is no access when we try to access the web page. Now let's check our logs again. When we refresh our page, you can see that the traffic of the IK user is blocked here, because this user does not have access permission. We only allowed it for the users in the IT user group. Within the HR group, you can choose the pages you want to access by creating a different rule. That's all we have to say in this lesson. Bye to see you in our next lesson.